Hi, I'm Dr. Willie Ong, a cardiologist. Let's talk about high blood pressure. There are around 25% of adults suffering from high blood pressure. For the treatment of this condition, there are hundreds of drugs in the market. So what's the best treatment for you? Well, you'll find out that the answer can be as simple as your ABCs. First, who has high blood pressure? It is true that an occasional rise in blood pressure, say during heavy exercise or extreme stress, usually does not warrant a label of hypertension. A person is said to be hypertensive if he or she has persistent elevations of blood pressure, which is a systolic blood pressure, the upper number, greater than 140 millimeters mercury, or a diastolic blood pressure, the lower number, of more than 90 millimeters mercury. For classification purposes, a person has mild hypertension if the systolic blood pressure is between 140 to 159 millimeters mercury, or a diastolic blood pressure of 90 to 99 millimeters mercury. These mild cases of high blood pressure may still respond to a change in lifestyle. Lose weight if you are overweight, exercise regularly, reduce salt intake, reduce fat intake, stop smoking, limit alcohol intake, and reduce stress. By contrast, the more serious label of moderate to severe hypertension refers to a systolic blood pressure higher than 160 or a diastolic blood pressure greater than 100 millimeters mercury. These serious elevations of blood pressure make one susceptible to a stroke or a heart attack. Hence, treatment with medications are needed. Regarding symptoms, actually many people don't experience any symptoms despite having high blood pressure. That is why hypertension is called a silent killer. Some people have headache, knee pains, feeling of heaviness over the head and chest area. Now, if lifestyle changes cannot control your blood pressure to normal levels, then we need to give you maintenance medications. The four classes of drugs used for high blood pressure begins with the letters A, B, C, and D. There are two classes of drugs which begin with the letter A. The first A stands for ACE inhibitors. Their generic names end with the common syllable pril, P-R-I-L. For example, enalapril, captopril, lisinopril. ACE inhibitors are good for hypertensive patients with diabetes or heart failure. Of course, people's bodies respond differently, and some people, around 5 to 10%, develop side effects of cough. Should you develop cough, then we can shift you to the second A for angiotensin receptor blockers. They are good alternatives. The ARBs, as they are called, end with the syllable sartan. For example, losartan, valsartan, telmisartan, irbesartan. In certain cases, doctors prefer the letter B for beta blockers. These drugs end with the syllables olol, O-L-O-L, such as metoprolol, atenolol, bisoprolol. Why are beta blockers so popular? Well, it has multiple health benefits. Treatment of high blood pressure, heart attack, angina or chest pain, and migraine. And they are also cheap. However, beta blockers are not as powerful in reducing your blood pressure, unlike the letter C's. Next, we have the C's for calcium channel blockers. They are the most powerful drugs at the doctor's disposal, and they usually end with the syllable PIN, P-I-N-E, like felodipine, amlodipine, lasidipine, and nifedipine. Calcium channel blockers can reduce very high levels of blood pressure. A widely prescribed drug is amlodipine, 5 mg tablet daily. Last but not the least, we have the D's for diuretics, such as hydrochlorothiazide, given at a low dose of 12.5 milligrams daily. Elderly patients respond well to low doses of diuretics, but we just have to watch out for potassium depletion. So if you're taking diuretics, take 2 bananas a day just to be safe. How long should one take these medicines? As I've said, mild cases of high blood pressure may still respond to a change in lifestyle, but for more severe cases, treatment is usually for many years, some for life. But don't worry, these drugs will really help you live much longer, up to 7 to 10 years more than your usual lifespan. So if your blood pressure is very high and cannot be controlled by lifestyle changes, then I would advise you to take maintenance medicines. See your doctor for the right medicine for you. It will surely prolong your life. God bless and take care, everyone.